So this is Liverpool Maternity Hospital. Is that still there, Mum?
No, this is Liverpool, Oxford Street, Liverpool Maternity Hospital, which no longer there. They've had a new women's hospital built in Liverpool.
And that was me in your arms after being born in the hospital.
Graham.
And now I'm being introduced to my cousin Ian. Yeah?
Yes. Graham, this was bringing him home from the hospital. And Ian, his cousin, and this is my sister Joanna and Brian, and cousin Susan. This was when she was going to be christened.
And
my dad and Hazel and Susan.
Hazel, your sister, your younger sister. My auntie Hazel.
My sister Hazel, and there's my lovely little boy, Graham.
So I'm the first one and the
there's
oldest on that side.
This was taken of Graham in his carry cot on top of the twin tub washing machine. He was just kicking about and just looking around and looking out the window and doing what babies do.
And how long had you been married at this stage?
We'd been married 7.5 years when you were born.
So you waited quite a while.
We did. We're very privileged to have our children. We waited longer than most. This was one taken in of Graham in his pram. I'm so proud of my Silver Cross posh pram. What happened to that pram? We left it in the loft when we moved house to New Zealand.
And you haven't seen it since?
No. This was a friend that lived locally, and that her little baby was born about the same, just after Graham, about 6 weeks later. And that she'd come round to visit to show her baby, bring her little baby, little boy round. Do you remember? She was a nurse. I'd made friends with. This was outside Lambton Road where we lived at that time. He was about 3 months old then. He was always very placid and never any problem.
And a classic car there, the dark blue Ford Anglia.
That our first car was after we were married was a Ford Anglia with the back sloping window. Even that's a that's that little boy's mother and father, Graham's. This little boy is John Dallison, my friend Barbara's little boy, and he's taking got his dad's camera box, and so he's going to take a camera a film as well. He's going to take a picture as well. John was about 3, and he's a vicar in Bournemouth.
Is he? He's a vicar now, that lad.
Yeah. Yes. This is Graham. There's my pram. I was ever so proud.
Was that the one to have the Silver Cross?
Absolutely, the top of the Rolls Royce of prams.
So how did you afford to buy the pram?
Well, we'd been 7.5 years married and we'd both worked. There's Dad holding Graham. He's probably about 4 months old there. And this was Chester. We'd been to Chester and we took him to see the ducks on the river bank. I don't remember him crying very much. He was just a happy little baby.
And do you remember where you were working at the time, Dad?
Oh, God.
You don't remember? Because you ended up working all
over. That's Chester Zoo. We must have gone to Chester Zoo at the same time. The other one was definitely Chester, unless that was Chester a different day. Graham's mode of travel was his potty, which he wasn't using at the time, but he was able to scoot about on it. And because he didn't walk, he talked very early, but he was about 15 months before he actually walked. But he liked to get about on his potty. These young girls used to come and take him a walk to the park. They used to knock on a Sunday morning. Dad would be working away. And this is Grandma Mac, Bernard's father. Nana Mac, as we called her. And this was taken at Bellevue Zoo.
There's Grandad Mac and Nana Mac there.
Yeah, Grandad Mac as well.
Did he always wear a hat?
Yes.
First World War veteran, wasn't he?
Yeah. I don't think Bellevue is no longer there. They certainly haven't got any elephants and animals, because there was a zoo type of thing there. And this is Bernard's sister Doris with Michael when they visit us at Lambton Road. And there's Michael pushing the pram. Michael's now got 4 children of his own and is about 10 grandchildren. There's Doris. I'm glad we got a picture of Doris. And this is in the backyard with a playpen. We didn't have a garden at Lambton Road. And I used to pop him in the... He's not walking here yet, but he likes to pull himself up and he could stand. But he oh, gosh. But he wasn't actually walking. So you weren't... I don't know whether you're a year old. I'm not sure. Yes.
Was it Morecambe?
This is at Morecambe where he was 13 months old. And there's a horse and we pat the horse's head. And I think that was probably our first holiday with Graham, because we'd stayed over, and we stayed over in Morecambe. I think we didn't stay over, we were just there for the day.
Just a day trip.
Yeah.
In the Anglia.
Probably.
And this is in Dinglefield.
Yeah. Opposite to us in Lambton Road, we had Dinglefield, we called it, and his cousins used to take him out there. He's walking by now, and popping about. His cousins will come into view. Paul now lives in Australia. He's got 2 children himself. And here's Elizabeth, his cousin, and Francis, and a friend of theirs. Forgotten her name, the little girl's name. And this was... I think we took him to... Oh, no, that'd be out just outside on the field opposite. Elizabeth is on the right. This little girl is Suzanne, who lived a few doors away from where we lived in Lambton Road. She's waving to the camera. You were having a little nose into the... into the pram. Oh, that's probably one of the few times you cried. Where was this? This was at Chester Zoo, I think, when it was bitter cold. We went one Easter and it was bitterly cold. It's a wonder the polar bears aren't there, because it felt like the polar region. That was Chester Zoo. It was an Easter time and it was really cold. It's amazing how you remember the weather. That's still in Chester's here.
Looks like I got the hang of the walking thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Once you're away, you were fine. It was just that you like to be sure before you. This is in Lambton Road again. It must have been near Christmas time because this was one of the Christmas presents he got. Father Christmas bought him a drum. How sad is that? When you buy your child a drum to bang. This one, I think, was Blackpool. And he gets a lovely ice cream. Oh, was it?
Yeah. Looks like out of Blackpool, yeah.
Yeah. We took him, that was a day trip to Blackpool. You like the ice cream?
And there's
the playground
a bit of football skills.
Yeah. The playground opposite Lambton Road. He's quite confident giving it a kick.
Looks like I'm giving Dad the run around.
Get over there. Or maybe he's chasing Dad for the ball.
So how old was I here then?
Well, you couldn't have been three because you went to live in Great Sankey when in 1966 and you were born in 64. So you must have only been about maybe two.
So
this is Paul, his cousin who now lives in Australia with his friend. I can't remember the other boy's name now. And this is Southport. We were out for the day in Southport and we met Barbara, my friend, with her son John. And shortly we'll see John on one of these roundabout cars.
So I certainly got plenty of days out then.
Yeah, of course you did. This is a little sandpit near the beach in Southport. And this is Barbara with Graham and John in the little boat. Barbara and I in the boat. We just met them by chance. They were in Southport the same day.
Really?
Yeah. So it was a thing that you did, you know what I mean? And these are I think these donkey rides were in, I think they were in Blackpool, were they? Can you remember, Bern? I know John is on the one of these rides here. In Southport, or maybe the donkeys were in Southport, I can't remember. Can you remember taking Graham on the donkeys?
Yeah.
Now this is Butlins at Filey. My brother Brian was working there and we'd gone over to see him for the day. I'm sure that was Filey.
This looks like the pier head.
This is Ian and Neil and Graham taken at Hillfoot Road where Joan and Ron had moved to in Hunts Cross. And we took Graham over for the day. It's just by coincidence. There's Richard with his hard hat. And this is my memory, a lasting memory of Richard and singing Hey Jude.
So he lived next door, so he automatically became my best mate.
Yes.
Because he was the same age.
You were born in June and he was born in August. Can't remember the date.
And we both walked to school together on the same day.
Yes.
There's his dad.
This is Tom, Richard's father next door.
I see Burtonwood Air Base was still fully active then.
Yes, and it must have been unique for me to decide to take a photo. Tom mending cars next door. You'll notice that the garden's probably still just as it was when you build a new house. It took a time to get them straight. They were, I'm sure that's Andrew Hunt joining the party. They played outside.
That looks like the Keegan's house, isn't it, over there?
It might be.
That's at Richard's house.
That's Richard's house.
There's his mum.
With Pat Thomas, Richard's mum, and Anne Hunt with Diane. Diane was only about 18 months old, and Graham was, it was about 2.5, I think.
I think her birthday was on the same day as mine as well.
Was it?
I think so, yeah.
You might be right. And this is Ian Keegan, must be the fourth musketeer.
So why did you move to the new house out of Liverpool?
We wanted a garden for Graham. We didn't have a garden. But Dad was working in... where was it in Manchester you were working? Mm. Oh, what's it called now? I know it. Now we go... When Dad was working away, he was working in South Wales at... Milford Haven. And this was a festival day, carnival day in Milford Haven itself, wasn't it? In the town, was it Milford Haven, where you know we went for the day and it was a festival, and.
But you were working down there, yes. So that was our holiday that year. We went and. We stayed in a caravan, didn't we?
Graham had his third birthday when we were living here, and this was the local clubs and what have you.
And I remember that third birthday because we went to a laundrette, and we came out the laundrette, and I'd been bought a tricycle with an elephant on the seat, and that was my third birthday present. I still remember that day.
I thought you walked into the shop with Dad and bought it.
All I remember is we went to do the washing. I ended up with a tricycle.
We went to Haverford West, and we went in a toy shop, and we bought him a little three-wheeler trike, little tricycle. And while we were away, when Bernard was working in South Wales with John, at wasn't Baglan Bay, was it? No, it was Milford Haven, and we stayed in a caravan, and that was a little girl whose parents were staying on the.
So this is the caravan site.
This is a caravan site, and that little boy's name was Hawkins. His surname.
Was it Peter Hawkins?
Peter Hawkins. That's right.
This is our Brody.
This is Brody, which was a Fleet Air Arms site. And John was working with Bernard, and he was invited in to the naval mess room. But Bernard wasn't allowed in because he hadn't been in the Navy. He was an army man. So the distinctions were there.
So they didn't welcome your dad then, because you were army?
Yeah. He went in
Pongo, is that what they call it?
So it was an air display at Brody. Was it airfield or an air? It was an air.
If it's Fleet Air Arm, yeah, it's the Navy flyers. Yeah.
And they were the Red Devils.
Yeah, well, they're army paratroopers, but they must have been part of it. Yeah, the show.
Well, they probably weren't allowed in the mess room.
Well, you can't get that. You see the people having a picnic where they. I mean, these days you can't go anywhere near where the paratroopers land.
Yeah.
But this is 1967. You could the access to things was, you know. It's a naval helicopter.
So there was all sorts of stunts going on and what have you. It was like a big open day and display, flying display. This was a cowboy outfit he got for Christmas, so he must have been about three then. And of course it was the dumb thing to go out. The garage was being built and Terry Beach was helping to lay some of the bricks. And
no, he was one of our neighbours, but you built the garage, didn't you?
Yes, Dad
yeah.
built
yeah,
the garage.
Laid all the bricks and built a garage in the back garden. Yeah. Which people don't do anymore. People don't go out and build a garage.
Lindsay was born in 1968. She was born at Warrington General Hospital. And Graham was looking at his baby sister.
I remember the first time we saw her, I wasn't allowed in. We had to look through the window from the car park, and it was snowing.
She was born on the 31st of March, and it was snowing outside, as you say, and you weren't allowed in the hospital. I was only in hospital for about 3 days. I think that's a little bit of a bored manner, isn't it?
Well, all of a sudden I'm not the centre of attention. This is a problem.
Yes.
And has continued to be one. Must have been sunny that day.
Yes.
Did you shoot this one?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think I was quite brave to have a go at shooting
it. You did all right. It's all framed
and
up
nicely. And there's
nice,
Terry Beach, the young Terry Beach. He was a neighbour and lived a few doors away and came to play with Graham and the other little kids in the road. And that's not a bad photograph. No.
It's pretty good.
Rolls Royce pram. I always say this. And now this was your fifth birthday, another sunny day. And that was Rita Hamilton's children. And that's Terry Beach and her brothers. There's Ian and Neil. And that was
my
Anne
cousins.
Beach.
Yeah.
Your cousins. That's
Joan
McAteer. And you'll find that's Pat Beach. And there's the Harbottles, Janet Harbottle. That was a different day in the pool. This was taken in the living room on the settee. And it was just bright sunlight. And Lindsay was just propped up in the chair.
And didn't we have that suite recovered?
We did.
We had it in a darker colour, a blacky browny.
Yeah, we had covers, but I didn't like them, so we ended up getting a new suite. This was see how happy she was, a happy baby as well. My children were happy. You weren't whingers. You were as good as gold, the pair of you. The garden's now straight with roses round the door. Can't ask for much more.
Yeah, all the work's gone in there. Garage has been built.
Yeah.
And that's my Uncle Brian, I think.
That's Uncle Brian, and Auntie Anna, who were my brother Brian's wife, Anna, had come down from Scotland with Jacqueline Ann in our Rolls Royce car, pram. I put her in the pram outside while Lindsay was probably having a little sleep upstairs or something like that. Where was this taken?
I think that's the back garden.
No, it's the front
garden, yeah.
Because there's no roses. That's Terry Beach and what was the other little girl's name?
Christine
Beach. She's a nurse now, married to a doctor.
He's dead now.
Terry Beach.
Oh, is he? Has he passed away?
Oh, yeah, quite a few years ago. We went to the funeral, didn't we, Ben? At St. Joseph's Church. I put the high chair outside. I think you could make it into a low chair as well. And that was... Do you know, young Terry was a really good cyclist into the, the French
Oh, like the Tour de France.
Yeah, he was into all that.
There's your older brother, my Uncle Peter.
Peter, and it was Trafalgar Square, where they don't have the pigeons anymore.
No.
You used to be able to buy the packets of bird
yeah,
food.
I think it was like the lid of an aerosol can that they used to sell them in. It's a squirrel, that's new. Because where did Peter live at
Peter
the time?
Lived in...
Oh,
gosh.
It was
in Essex, wasn't it? Wasn't it Essex? And that's Auntie Beryl, who's passed away now. My sister Beryl. They lived in... where was it they lived? Can you remember?
Where Peter lived.
Yeah. Famous. Gans Hill. Gans Hill it was. In Essex. Because he worked for the Ford Motor Company in Dagenham. As a, you know, engineer where they used to time how much each job took. What do they call them? Time and motion. Yeah, he was a time and motion man.
There's but Terry.
There's oh. Terry.
There's the garage you built. Mm. A paddling pool full of fun.
Look at all the kids. I like the kids in my back garden because if they were getting any, that was Ann Beach. If they got into any problems or any fights of any sort, I could sort them out.
Everybody in the street was very similar. It was families, young families with kids, wasn't
yeah.
it? So every
yeah.
was, you know, everyone had something in common.
Yes.
They were all at that same stage in life.
Yes. The children were all born about the same time. Now this was. I've got a feeling.
I think it might be the Isle of Wight. I think it might be the first trip to the Isle of Wight, I think. No, it's
Margate.
It's Margate, it's way
yeah.
before that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, our first holiday in Margate. Or was it the first one? We stayed in a hotel at first, or a boarding house, and then we.
This was a thing called the Lido, wasn't
yes.
it? It was a big salt water swimming pool.
And that's Auntie, that's Beryl, my sister, who's no longer with us. And that was a couple that we got talking to, I think, at the hotel. And Graham digging for Australia. Beryl posing. She came to visit, she lived in London, and she came to see us at when we were at Margate. And we, from there, we used to go to the Butlins Hotels because there was more going on than in the other hotel, the just boarding house. That couple were from Birmingham. Lindsay was only about, she walked when she was a year old. That was the Lido at Margate, which I don't think is there anymore.
Mm. I remember it had a huge high diving board. And
Dad took you in, I think he took Lindsay in. And I think he probably took Graham in as well. That'll be the first experience of this, I think, was Cambridge. We went to, oh no, it's London Zoo. What happened? We went to somebody's wedding.
This looks like Cambridge.
Yeah. Peter lived in Cambridge and we went to visit him. And we went to, that's King's College, Cambridge. And we went out to the, it was an outdoor swimming pool which we took the children to. I think Lindsay was about 17 months.
She had the blondest hair then, didn't she?
She had hardly any hair when she was tiny. And this is the outdoor swimming pool,
paddling
pool. And when she got her costume wet, she took the bottoms off, because she didn't like the wet pants on her. This isn't Lindsay, this is Graham. He's trying to empty the pool. And she was following what you did. Is that attention seeking?
Yeah, I think so.
Because she's getting all the attention. Now, where was the... they were at Southport. Another day trip to Southport, and we were on the, what do you call them?
Trampolines.
I think you're getting quite good at that.
Doing tricks now. So this is in the house in Hale
Grove. Yes. That's the window outside.
So you must have shot this one as well.
Must have done.
Now where's this fire
engines? Where was that? Can you remember where the fire engines were, Ben? Is it the pierhead?
I think it is the pierhead. Has Lindsay got a poncho on?
Yes.
Were they the thing to have in the
70s? Yes, yes.
Now this is the Isle of Wight.
Yes.
First trip.
We'd been to the wedding at you'll probably find Auntie Joan and Uncle Len on it, because we'd been to Stephen's wedding. And then we'd gone on holiday to the Isle of Wight with Joan and Len. I think that's the time. We had several holidays to the Isle of Wight.
And I know we went to Portsmouth for the day on the hovercraft.
Yes.
And this is the hovercraft arriving to take us from the end of Ryde Pier, I think.
Yes.
We went to see HMS Victory.
Yes. But was that when Joan and Len was with us?
Well, that's
Victory.
Victory.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, and you know, in it's naval people showing you round, and when the groups were leaving the Victory, one of the sailors said, "Thank you, sir," and jingle a couple of coppers in his cap.
Oh, as if someone's thrown one in.
Yeah, and then the all the visitors who'd been on would contribute. I think that's the Isle of Wight.
Yeah.
This mustn't have been when Joan and Len came with us, because I think they would have...
We went at least 2 years on the run, didn't
yeah.
we? We went to Sandown.
Is that Carisbrook Castle in the Isle of Wight?
Yeah. Oh, Lindsay's not having a good day.
She's got a bit of a mardy lip on her. You're trying to, and she doesn't, that's the Isle of Wight. I think that was at, what part of the Isle of Wight was that, where they had Black Gang Chine? So you have plenty of days out and holidays.
Yeah, oh yeah.
But I don't know whether other kids got as many as us. I don't know. We went away every year, I would say, wouldn't you? That's Ventnor. That's definitely Ventnor in the Isle of Wight. That was a map of the Isle of Wight. Yeah. And that's where Dad got stung by a bee as he sat down on a deck chair. I don't know whether you remember that. He went a pale colour, I can tell you.
Didn't we go there on an open top bus?
Yes.
Yeah.
That looks like where the coloured sands are.
Allen Bay.
It is. That's why we're showing you the coloured sands in the rock formation.
And this is the ferry.
Yes.
With all the British made cars on it.
Look, yes.
Every single car's British. No Japanese, no German, no Italian. They're all Austins, Morris's.
Morris's and Austins. What did we have?
At that time we had a Hillman Minx, didn't we?
Did we?
I think we did. Or a Morris Oxford.
And this is the Isle of Wight. And I don't know why they've got the balloons, but this is the dolphins. You used to pay to go and see the dolphins performing in a pool.
I think there was only one, wasn't there, as well?
I think there was. I can't remember which part of the Isle of Wight it was. Yeah, it goes through the hoops. Can you remember which part of the Isle of Wight? That pool was where the dolphins were.
Yeah.
Where? What part of it?
Was it Sandown or Shanklin?
Oh.
Was it in Sandown or Shanklin?
It was one of the...
I remember it was upstairs. It was like on a roof.
Yes, that's right. This is Black Gang Chine, where they had all the prehistoric animals, the terror whatever. Is that right? Is it a Black Gang Chine? Yeah, I think it is, yes. Oh, she's ever so brave.
I don't think they were anatomically correct. I don't think that the real one smiled and had big eyes.
Well, maybe they made them so they didn't frighten the kids. Tyrannosaurus Rex or something, isn't it?
Yeah.
It might have, I don't know whether it was Ventnor, I don't know. That was definitely Black Gown Chai. Is this the waiting for the hovercraft, is it, or the...
I think that's cows.
It might be, yes, I think it is.
That was in Ryde.
Ryde.
That's Ryde. Well, I think we went to Ryde the first time we went to the Isle of Wight. Didn't we? And then we stayed at Sandown. I think you're right, Bernard. I think that was right. You know, over those couple of years, you didn't seem to grow up very... You stayed the same a while. Do you know what... Do you agree with that?
I suppose so. This is a day out in Jodrell Bank, isn't it?
Yes.
Because the thing used to get back from holiday and you hadn't shot all the cine film and you had to use it up. So the next day out we went on, you'd use up the rest of the film so you could send it away and get it developed.
Yes, that would be right.
Yeah.
It looks as if it was quite a cold day because Lindsay had a coat on. And another time, Brian came over and you went to Jodrell Bank with Brian.
Mm.
And of course, there was a big. Now, this is Auntie Joan and Uncle Len. And Lindsay had been a bridesmaid in Wokingham at Stephen and Heather's wedding. And then we went to the Iron and White with them on holiday. And here's Uncle Len coming with the tea. He'd been to get the tea. Now, can you remember where it was in the Isle of Wight when we stayed with Joan and Len?
I can't remember.
This is Trafalgar Square.
I think Lindsay's concentrating too hard.
You're pushing her away because they're my pigeons. And this is, we went to London. And there's Auntie Joan. My Auntie Joan, my dad's sister. That's, I think it's outside Horse Guards Parade.
There's Downing
there's
Street.
Number 10.
So you can't walk down there anymore.
You can, you...
It's all gated off.
That's right. Buckingham Palace. Westminster, oh, the Big Ben.
Tower Bridge looks a lot better these days since they cleaned it up.
Yes. And this is the Isle of Wight. And Auntie Joan was really good at making the sandcastles.
Did we have anything to do with making the sandcastle at all?
You were supposed to be.
Was it all Joan?
You were supposed to, but I think you got fed up with it. You were just performing to the camera. You probably helped knock it down.
Now, this was our first... overseas holiday.
To Mallorca.
There's the Stairway to Nowhere in Mallorca, first time we went to Mallorca.
Yeah.
Which is what happened with a lot of families in the early 70s, people went on holiday to the UK. And then in the mid to late 70s, people started going to different parts of Europe.
Yes. The Crazy Golf.
I think Lindsay's cheating there somewhere. I don't think that's how it's supposed to work.
I think we were looking for a glass factory behind the cathedral.
In Palma.
And because Dad and I had been to Mallorca and that we'd been to a glass factory, and I think the motorway was... I don't think the glass factory was there anymore. That looks to me it was with where you went to the caves of Drac, and they had the peacocks there, and you went into the underground caves. We probably didn't. This was Mallorca when Peter and Joy were there, and.
Charity had ended up, once she pushed him in the pool, she ended up falling in the pool behind.
She did, yes. That's young Peter pushing Daddy into the pool. That was, we had gone over to their hotel at Arundel. And then they came over to our hotel, which was a palm and over. That was that's the hotel, And that sandpit was just near the by the barn and over.
Wasn't this the glass bottom boat ride where they took us out to like a little beach?
And I had sangria and came back as drunk as a lord. Do you remember that?
Glass bottom boat. This is the airport again on the way back. This is Scotland.
Yes, yeah. We went up to see Brian, and this is Jacqueline Anne. I don't know whether it was Brenda Teresa. That's Jacqueline, and that's Lindsay, I think. Brenda was on her mum's knee. That's Brenda there. She's now in Australia. She lives at Kalgoorlie. She's only young there, isn't she? There's Brian. This is Mallorca with Hazel and Ian. Had a couple of holidays in Mallorca on our own, and then we went on a holiday with Hazel and Ian. Do you remember?
This is Bewley, isn't it? The Motor Museum, and we stayed in Bournemouth.
Yes.
And this is Stonehenge, which is all roped off now.
That's right, many years been roped off. But you could go right up to them, couldn't you? Was that a map or something?
Yeah, it must have been.
They're going to sort of make it more inaccessible, putting roads in and things like that. This is Hazel and Ian in Mallorca with us. We stayed in a different part. I can't remember the name of the place we stayed.
And weren't the Nottingham Forest football team staying in the next hotel? And there's a football pitch outside. And Brian Clough was staying there with Nigel Clough.
I think that was when we were at Palma Nova. This is another one, another hotel. I've forgotten the name of the place. There's Victoria. She'd go mad if she could see that now. Should have showed it on her wedding day. Oh, what's the name of the hotel? It might come up.
Well, there was the Santa Lucia in Palma Nova. And this one, was it the Baia d'Este?
Oh, it was Baia d'Este. And to get the donkey to, you had to, Harry to make it go, because it would stop. See, the donkey would stop and he'd say hurry, hurry, hurry to make the donkey go. It is Hazel. I thought I saw your dad in the horse and cart thing.
It's not quite Charlton Heston, is it?
Not quite. I'll tell you what. The donkey looks all in. Biodiversity, that was the name of the hotel. Lindsay with her armbands. She goes swimming nearly every day now, you know. She goes to the village inn and she's like got a membership, you know, like a, and she swims quite often. That was, we were waiting to go home, we were going that day, and you know when you don't do very much but hang around the pool because you're going home. Don't know whether it was late afternoon, but you know you have to clear the room by lunchtime, things like that. We've been on a few of those planes. During our lifetime, haven't we? Been how many times have you been around the world?
I think I've been around 3 times before I was 21.
Yeah, I think we've been around about 7 times around the world. This looks like a different hotel.
This looks, well, that, this looks like another trip to Mallorca. Did we go again after? Oh yeah, we went to Palma, didn't we? Didn't we? No, we went to Magaluf.
Magaluf,
and stayed in the Magaluf Park.
Yeah, we did. And that's when we went to, when we went on the old train to, what was the name of the place?
Was it Inca?
No, it wasn't Inca.
That, I think that's a view of Inca.
Yes. What was the name of that place that we used to... you get the train from Palma. Oh, I've forgotten the name of it. Gosh, you think you know these things. Oh. Now, this is funny because Lindsay goes to buy a purse and she...
Actually, I think that's later on.
Oh, is it?
I think. I don't know.
And she stands with the behind a tree.
Yeah, that's coming up. That's coming up.
Was that Magaluf?
That was either Magaluf or Italy when that happened.
Oh, that was Italy. This is Magaluf, I think, so it wouldn't be on this one. Oh, that was that water polo. Yeah. Butlin's Ocean Hotel.
This was Saltdean near Brighton,
yes,
wasn't it?
Well, they've built up all apartments where the hotel is.
And I didn't know what I was doing there, so I hit the ball from left to right, but it actually lands from right to left. So this isn't the Butlins Hotel anymore?
No. The big apartments there, like McCarthy Stone or something like that. Last time we passed. Was my mum wasn't with us, was she?
I don't know.
Cause we, oh, that's Venice.
Yeah, this is our last overseas trip.
Was it?
I think we did St Ives in Cornwall after,
yes,
this, that we didn't film.
Yeah.
But this was our last one as a family that we went on.
Yeah.
We stayed in Lido de Gesola, didn't we?
We did.
And we went for a day trip to Venice.
Yes.
And really liked it, so we went back a different way. I think we went on a boat the second time.
Yes, we did. And your dad bought ice creams, and they were awfully dear. Can't remember. I mean, they were probably 50 pound pence here, but they were about £2 there, because they saw they saw us coming, and we went to the where the square. Bit hazy. That's probably the Rialto Bridge.
Venice hasn't changed a bit. It's exactly like that today.
When you went on that motorbike in Italy?
Yeah.
Were you 16?
Yeah.
And you could ride a motorbike.
I think
it was a scooter.
Yeah, I think you could go on from about 14. You didn't even need a helmet.
Yeah.
You just needed a passport. You didn't need a license. That's where I said, yeah, walk along here and stand and look at something. So she stood right behind a tree.
Oh, classic. Well, that was in when we were staying in Lido di Lessina. What is it?
Lido di Gesso.
Yeah.
We had to pay to go on the beach.
Yes.
So all the hotels had them sectioned off.
Yeah.
For the hotel section.
Some advert on there, you can't read it, I don't think. It's probably in Italian anyway. There's two lads staying in the hotel as well, from Bradford. There's Dad with my hat on. But I would say we were probably trendsetters, because I don't think Richard would have gone on overseas as often as we did.
And that's it.
You see, you can't recapture that.